Ever feel like you spend more time managing spreadsheets than actually using them to get things done? In this video, we're going to look at a new AI-powered spreadsheet app that does the work for you. No more formulas, no more hours of data cleanup, just answers. And best of all, it's free to use. Let's dive in. First, head to this website. You could click on the link in the top right-hand corner, and I've also included a link down in the description. On this website, click on sign in or sign up if you don't have an account yet. Again, it's completely free to sign up and to start using. Once you finish signing in, you'll land here in the main Bricks interface, and we're here to check out this next generation AI spreadsheet. Over on the left-hand side, we'll see that there's a section called the grid. This is what Bricks refers to as a spreadsheet or a workbook. Let's click into this. This drops us into a brand new spreadsheet or a grid of a whole bunch of different cells, hence the name. At first glance, this appears to be just your standard spreadsheet, and it can do all the stuff that you would expect a spreadsheet app to do, like say Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets. Here, I can enter in some numbers. Let's type in a whole bunch of numbers, and I can enter in a function. Let's type in sum. And here I could sum up all the numbers above. Let's hit enter, and it works just like we would expect it to. But we came here to see the AI capabilities. So let's delete this, and I'm going to paste in some data to help us with our analysis. If you would like to follow along, I've included a link to a CSV file in the description down below. Let's now paste the data. I'll click into cell A1, and then here I'll paste it. This is sales data for the Kevin Cookie Company. To be able to see all of these columns better, let's click right up here, and then we could expand the width of the columns. That looks a lot better. One thing you might notice is it automatically converted all of this data into a table. Making it a table makes it easier for the AI to analyze, interpret, and to generate insights. Before we start working with this data, let's give this table a new name. This is not required, but it'll make it easier to reference this table later on. Right up above, we see the current name table 01, and that's not that descriptive. So let's click on that, and here I could type in sales data, and then I'll click out, and there we have a new name for the table. If you've ever had to analyze data before, you know that one of the biggest time consumers is just cleaning the data and getting it ready for analysis. If we look down below, here we have a column with the date, and overall, this looks fine. If we look at column B though, it looks like there's the product, comma, the location. We've conflated these two different items into one column. I don't know, the cookie company does not hire the best and brightest people. And if we look over at column C, we have the units sold. So I need to clean this data first before I could analyze it. And I want to start by separating the product from the location into two new columns. In the past, I would probably use a formula or a function to do this. But let's instead see if we can use AI. If we look down at the bottom, we have this text field, and it has some text that says, ask the AI to do anything, including UI actions. Now, it says anything, so let's try something. Right over here, I'll type in the prompt, add a new column with the product. I want to pull the product out into a new column, and let's send that through. Up above, we now have a new column with the product. Let's now see if we can pull out the location. I'll type in another prompt, add a new column with the location, and let's send that. Right up above, we now have a new column with the location. So there it successfully extracted all the information from this column. I no longer have a need for column C. So let's click on this column, right click, and then let's go down to delete, and let's delete this column. Now that we have columns with the product and also the location, I need to add another column with the state that all of these cities are in. Management likes having that when they review the data, and for whatever reason, the team that collects this data never includes it. It always ends up on me. But I now have AI as a secret weapon. Down below, let's see if maybe it could help me add a column with that. I'll type in a prompt, add a column with the state that the city is in, and let's send that. Up above, there's now a new column with the state for all of these different locations. Look at how easy that was. Should I tell management how easy this is? Or should I simply take longer lunch breaks? Let me know in the comments. To help me with my analysis, I need to enter in the unit cost for each one of these products. Now, I don't have any type of cost over here. So let me go over in my spreadsheet and let me paste in a table. I have all the different products and the unit cost for those different products. Now, I want to pull in the unit cost from this table for these different cookies, and I want to attach it to all the different cookies in this table. In the past, I would need to use something like VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP to pull in all those different unit costs. But again, let's see if maybe AI can help. Down below, let's go to the text field. Let's try typing this out together. Let's say add a new column, and I want to add a new column in my sales data table. So over here, I'll type in sales data, and here it automatically identifies this table. I'll select that, and it highlights that table name. So add a new column in sales data with the, let's say, the unit cost. Over here, when I start typing in unit, it identifies that there's a unit cost in table one. So let's select that. So add a new column in sales data with the unit cost from table one. I think that's good enough. So let's send that through and see if it can make that connection between the two tables. And what do you know? If we look right here, we now have the unit cost. Here we have oatmeal raisin, and it costs $2.25. If I go over to my original table, here we have oatmeal raisin, and it does indeed cost $2.25. Down below, we can also see how it went about doing this. Here it says, I will add a new column named unit cost to the sales data table. The column will be populated by matching the product column in the sales data with the product column in table one. So here you get a little bit of background on how it went about making that connection. I think this looks good. So over here, I'll click on close. I'm feeling really good. So let's continue going. Down below, let's see if we could add a new column showing me the total revenue. There's a new column with the total revenue, the unit sold multiplied by the unit cost. Let's keep going. Over here, let's see if we can make a table showing me the best selling products. Management always wants to know what sells the best. It's now generated a table with all of the best selling products. It looks like chocolate chip is still at the top, and snickerdoodle does the worst. Let's keep going. Down below, let's type in another one. Are there any revenue patterns? This one's getting a little bit more complex. Let's see what it comes back with. Up above, it inserted a pivot table with all of the different products and all the different locations, and then the revenue for those different combinations. I can now look through this to see if anything stands out to me. Let's try another one. Let's try some predictive modeling. Let's see if it could forecast what next month will look like based on the previous months. Above, it's inserted a new table where it forecasts the revenue based on all of the existing data. And here it says that it applied a simple linear regression model. I don't think I'd be able to do that on my own, but here it came up with a forecast. Interesting. Now that I've done all of this analysis and I've looked at all of this data, management also wants me to pull together some type of dashboard that they can present. So let's try the hardest prompt of today. Down below, I'll type in, can you make a dashboard showing me insights on this data using tables and charts? Let's send that. This drops me into a brand new dashboard. Over on the left-hand side, we can see that I'm now in a dashboard. The data is all still there in the grid. I can click back to it, and here I can see all of my data. But let's go back to the dashboard. Here, it summarizes and gives me insights into all of my data. Let's have a quick look. Over here, I can see all my best-selling products by unit sold. Here I have a nice visual. I can see the revenue distribution by product. Here it has total revenue by product. I have my forecasted revenue for December 2024. And here I have different tables that I generated on the previous sheet. I have all sorts of different insights into my data. Of course, if I would like additional views, down below I could ask the AI to add more. One thing that's really neat is all these different components on this dashboard can be edited. Here, for example, I have the revenue distribution by product. And over here, I could go back and I could edit the original data. When I click on edit data, that brings me back to this table on the original grid that we were working on. And then I can make edits. And once I make edits here, it'll automatically update this dashboard. I can also click into this visual and we can edit the visual right up on top. I'll click on edit. And this opens up a view where I can adjust all the different pieces and components that make up this visual. Let's close out of this. Although AI pulled together this dashboard for me, I still have full control over what's presented in this view. Let's continue using AI to tweak this view. Here I have some text that calls out what this dashboard provides. I'll click on this, and over here I can click on this icon to open up the AI, and I could use it to improve the writing, fix spelling and grammar, make it shorter, or something else. Let's say, can you turn this into paragraph form, and then click on generate. And look at that, we now have it in paragraph form. I think this is all ready now to share with management, and I have a few different ways that I can do that. Right up on top, I can click on Present, and this launches presentation mode, where we could go through and we could look at all the different insights and all of the data. I'll press Escape to cancel out of that. I could also share it out with the broader team. I'll click on Share, and over here, I could type in an email address, I can copy a link, and I could even publish it to the internet for anyone to see. This is all so exciting. I didn't have to enter in a single formula or function. With just a few natural language prompts, I got a beautiful dashboard based on my data in just minutes. Now, honestly, this is a game changer for anyone who works with spreadsheets. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Do you think this will help you save a lot of time? To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.